everyone, you are watching Atmosphere, and in this video we will be discussing about scope, placement and salary after doing architecture. In architecture college you will be spending your 5 years of life and you will be designing and you will be learning a lot about architecture. But what after college? What will be the scope and what will be the placement and what are the salary that you will be getting after doing architecture? In this video, we will be covering all of the doubts that you will be having regarding these questions. So first of all, I want to tell you that architecture is a professional course and it's a professional degree. So what is the plus point of a professional degree is that either you can work on a salary based, like you can join a firm and you can work there. So that is the common thing. But what is the advantage of professional course is that after getting your degree, you get license from Council of Architecture and that allowed you to open your own firm and open your own office, and you can take project from the market and you can work on it. So that's the benefit of having a professional degree. You can work directly with the clients. So you are not restricted to doing job. You can open your own thing and you can run your own offices. So that's the plus point of doing a professional degree and doing architecture. After 5 years of college, you have to get a job. And what is the procedure? Let's talk about that. So what happened in architecture is that there are very less placement that happens in college level. So I'm from School of Planning and Architecture, Delhi, and what happens there in placement cell is that students have to approach these MNCs and companies and they have to write mail to them and they have to tell them that they are having a placement cell, and if they are interested they can join these placement cell and hire our students. So it's like that. And what happened in placement cell is that if students are interested in joining placement cell, they go there and they get jobs in placement cell. Placement cell doesn't happen every year. If students are interested, they definitely can call these MNCs and call these firms. So it depends on the student, either they want to call the placement cell or not. This was about placement cell, but I want to clarify that what happened in architecture is that every individual have a different design sense and they do a different type of project and they specialize in that. And as a student, if a person want to work under someone, they just have to send their mail and they have to attach their portfolio with that I have done these type of project in my college and I want to work with your firm and with your company. So that is the approach that you can do, and you don't have to go for placement cell if you really want to work under someone, and that's the direct way you can approach them. So there is actually no need of placement cell, but that placement cell also helps student to explore things and explore different type of companies. So there's a plus point of appearing for placement cell as well. And you can, if you are not getting what you want from placement cell, you can definitely approach these firms. So this was the process of how you can get your job either by placement cell or either approaching to different firms and MNCs where you want to work. There's one more question related to placement that is a good college matter in case of a placement. I want to clarify that good college does matter, but it's up to an extent. Like if you have a really good portfolio and whatever is the name of your college, it doesn't matter. So portfolio will be speaking for yourself and your personality during interviews and everything will be speaking a lot rather than just your college. So I would suggest that improve your portfolio, improve yourself, improve your personality. So that's the thing that they will be looking instead of your college. And yes, there's a plus point of doing your architecture from good college because it attracts good students and you have a really good faculty. So a total atmosphere will be really good in your learning and you will definitely will be having a good personality and you will be also having a lot of good projects that you have done in your academic year. So that will be the plus point of a good college. And even this placement cell knows, they have a set mind that okay, he belongs to this college, so his work might be good, but if the work is not good then they won't be hiring you. So that's the logic behind a good college for placement. So let's talk about the salary after doing architecture. So what happened in college is that you will be working on unreal project and you will be exploring your creative side of architecture. But what happened in reality is that after 5 years, you have to work on real scale and you have to work on real project. And As a fresher, you will be hardly getting around 15k to 25k per month. Okay, so that is the most that you can get, and at max you can get 30 to 35 if you are really good in your portfolio and if you are really good in what you do. So that is the rough idea of the salary that you can get. And what happened after is that after getting experience of 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, so what happens, you are learning a lot and you can work properly. So what is your salary will be having is you will be getting appraisal of 10 to 15% every year, and your salary will definitely raise. So that is the minimum that I was telling. And after 5 year, what happens is that you will be a full-fledged architect and you will be having a lot of experience with you. So definitely your salary will be improving and you can touch more than 60, 70 and even 1 lakh depending on the scenario, depending upon the city, and various things are involved deciding your salary. Because in metro city, in a big city, you will be paid more, and in a smaller city, you won't be getting much. After doing your architecture degree and after doing your bachelor, what happens is that you can definitely improve your salary by following these things. So the first thing that you can do after doing your bachelor degree is that you can apply for master for specialization. And this specialization can be in anything. Masters in urban design, masters in urban planning, masters in anything. Whatever you are interested, you can do that. And what happens is that after completing your masters, you will be getting a salary package because you definitely have done a specialization on a course. And if someone is needing that specialization, they will definitely pay you more than a bachelor degree. So that's the plus point of doing master. After doing your master, you can definitely get a hike in your salary, and you can get an average salary of 50k to 70k per month after doing your master. So that is the rough range that you can get, and even you can get more than that. Second option that you can do is that after doing your bachelor, you will be needing a little bit of field experience. Have that, and after that you can open your own firm and open your own studio, and you will be running an office. And what you will be needing is that you will be just needing client, and you have experience, so you have to build a relation in the field, and you will be getting your own project and you can work on that, and that will be totally under you. You will be the head designer and you will be designing. So that is the plus point of doing architecture, because you will be having your license and you can definitely run your own firm with very few requirements. That you will be needing a office space, and you will be needing your team if you want, and a basic setup will be required to start your office, and you can definitely run your office after that. Running your own firm, you can earn a lot because the client will be in direct touch with you, and whatever you will be quoting for your design, you will be earning that much directly, and there will not be any scenario in which like you will be getting less. So you can earn whatever you want, and you can do a lot of projects at a time, and you can earn a lot. So that is a plus point of a firm. And I can range you that you can earn per month 1 lakh to 2 lakh and even more than that, depending upon where, how many projects you are getting and how many client you have. So that is the plus point of running your own firm and running your own business. Third option after doing your bachelor is that you can go for government job and you can work in government sector. So there are many government organizations that need architects, such as developing authorities and metro corporation, ISRO. There are many things that require architects in government sector, and you will be having your government salary that can be, the starting salary could be much more high than a private sector because it's a government sector. But the thing is that you have to qualify their competitive exams after bachelor's, and you have to appear for GATE, and there are many exams that you have to qualify to get into government job. The earning range of government sector will be starting from 50 to 60 thousand, and if you are getting into a senior architecture post, then you can earn more than 1 lakh depending upon the vacancy and depending upon the salary and depending upon the location. So you can definitely get a government job in architecture. So So these are the three things that you can do after architecture. And you might be thinking that at start you will be getting very less money, and you have spent your 5 years in architecture. So what is the point of doing architecture? So guys, let me tell you that the skill set will be improving day by day, and at start you may earn very less, but the end will definitely going to be fruitful. And I have seen a lot of architects around, and they are getting a really good lifestyle. And what is the best point of architecture is that you will be having a very creative side of yourself that is being explored throughout your life, and your project will be in real scale. Like example, you will be designing a house for someone and they will be using it, and they will be praising you for that, for the design that you have given to their house. So that is the best point of doing architecture. The satisfaction that you get after doing architecture might be totally different from any other course. So that is the plus point, and you can earn a lot. I have told you the three ways that you can earn. Totally depend upon your skill set, your potential. You can definitely raise your salary to limitless. So that is the thing that you can do with your salary as well. So it's not like that you will be having your salary pressure and you will be earning less throughout your life. You will be definitely can get a great hike at any moment because your work will be improving day by day. So one more thing, that after spending a bit of time to your journey, you will be starting by as a junior architect, and definitely after a few years you will be a senior executive architect, and then after that you can definitely become a manager. You can definitely govern a lot of things in the organization and MNCs. Like, you can be a manager, and after that in your seniority level you can even become a project manager. So you will be having the whole control on the project. So this is the raise that you will be getting after every year and after every experience that you get. Question I want to answer is that people ask whether they can go abroad for doing architecture. So it's the yes. People can definitely practice anywhere where they want to work, and they just have to send their portfolio and send their work and mail to the firm that they are willing to work abroad. And if they accept you and if they like your work, they definitely will call you up, and you can work there as well. So it's the plus point that you can work worldwide, but you have to understand their codes and understand the difference between Indian architecture and the architecture that is being practiced there. So that is the difference you will be getting, but you can definitely manage it because you will be learning there also. So at starting you might have problem, but yeah, slowly and gradually you can earn there also, and you can definitely work abroad. So that was the answer. If you like this video, please hit the like button, and please subscribe to my channel. I have seen that people are viewing my videos but they are not subscribing. So what is going on, guys? Please subscribe to my channel. So guys, please follow me on Instagram as well, and the handle is given here, and the link to the Instagram page is given in the description. You can follow me, and you can ask any doubt regarding architecture there. And one more thing is that I will be uploading new content on Instagram, so I will be working on my Instagram page from now. So please follow me on Instagram, and you will be learning a lot from my Instagram page as well. Bye bye till then, and see you next time.